instead of kind of blaming how modern men are, can we instead challenge ourselves to engage with the world differently and in a way that creates more opportunities to get the interactions that we want? I really want to help you to put the fun and joy back into being single and being part of the dating process. If right now you're starting to believe that no good single men exist, please let me help you to meet them by showing you the art of how you can encourage him to come over and say hello to you in real life. I'm dating coach Hayley Quinn, and for over 10 years, I've helped both men and women to meet one another and really connect. And I know that the ultimate fantasy way that we would all love to meet someone is we're just hanging out with our friends, and then suddenly an amazing guy walks right up to us and goes, "You." Well, maybe he says something a bit more than that, but you get what I mean. If you find like going out in real life, you don't know how to start to talk to guys, or that men all seem to be intimidated by you and no one's saying hello to you, and because of that, you feel you have to rely on online dating, I want to now teach you some kind of little secret steps here to how to really encourage him to put one foot in front of the other and meet you in person. So first of all, I want you to recognize there are so many great, amazing men out there for you. I know dating doesn't always feel like this. I know sometimes dating feels like there's no good options left, and in fact, you keep just meeting the wrong people over and over again. Now, the thing is, when I'm coaching women around dating, and particularly when I'm doing practical training with them around meeting men in real life, they are usually completely astounded by how many more men switch on to the prospect of meeting them when they start to actually engage with the world a little bit differently. Not all men are born these swashbuckling heroes. Actually, just like us, guys have their own anxieties and fears around the process of dating as a whole. So if he's not walking up to you and sweeping you off your feet just yet, it could well be that he wants to, but he doesn't feel secure enough in himself that he's going to be able to do that. So rather than seeing the guys not approaching you as a signal of your lack of self-worth, or you're not good enough, or you're not attractive enough, instead to start to think about it like what you need to do is find the piece of the puzzle which enables him to feel more comfortable to make that connection with you. And really, when it comes to meeting people, whether it's on or offline, dating isn't a one-way process. It's not all about him actually making all of those first moves. In fact, as a woman looking to meet a man, there's a lot that you can do to be proactive in a way that's still subtle and still feminine. So in just a second, we're going to look at three kind of cool ways you can encourage him to start that conversation with you. But before we get into that, I just want to remind you that the reason he may not be approaching you right now is actually nothing to do with you. His main fear within the dating process is going to be a fear of rejection. He's going to worry that basically after psyching himself up to talk to you, after really thinking about what to say, that he's going to walk up to you, or even worse, you and your friends, and you're going to shoot him down, or you're going to ignore him. So the tools that we're going to work with now are all about, first of all, of course, getting him to recognize that you are physically there, but also to allow his fear of rejection to reduce. Now, that could be that you send a stronger signal by smiling at him. It could be that you move a bit closer to him so he has to come less far to talk to you. He probably just needs a bit of a platform in order to have some context to say hello to you. So my first action step that you can take in order to successfully encourage more men to approach you is to create some context for him. By context, I mean a reason. So if you say something really simple like, "Can you watch my laptop?" or, "Hey, do you mind just saving that yoga mat for me?" immediately he has a reason to continue the conversation. He also knows that because you've begun it, that you are approachable and friendly, and you're not going to shoot him down if he then moves things forwards. So sometimes by us taking a small piece of initiative to show that we're open to talking and to start the conversation off, even if it's something relatively banal, it can really give him a platform and a context to take that conversation to the next level. The second way you can encourage more men to interact with you in real life is you can do things that will help him to feel good about himself. We all like to feel good about ourselves, and sometimes one of the most effective ways of doing that is to be able to say thank you to someone, Or if we give someone almost like a little mini challenge, or we ask something nicely of someone, and if they then go ahead and fulfill it, they'll feel that reward of, hey, I did something pretty good there, and it will create a really nice positive feedback loop. So I know, trust me, as a mumpreneur here, I really know that we are all capable of like carrying our own bags or carrying our own drinks from the bar or Googling something, you know, the way to a place. However, if we can instead be okay to receive in the sense of being okay to ask for support or help, that really gives him a great platform again where he can show up for you as being helpful, as being engaged, and that will allow him to feel masculine and confident. So if you can ask him to help you carry your drinks from the bar, or you know, you're getting confused by Google Maps and do you know the way to XYZ, as cheesy as it sounds, if he's a man who's switched on to meeting more women, he will feel great about the fact that someone's asked him for this help. And once, of course, that he's given you that help and assistance, if you can say, you know, thank you, that was, I was getting really stuck there, or thank you, I just didn't have enough hands, and pause, in that moment, he's gonna have a really great opportunity again then to lead the conversation forwards. So when it comes to encouraging men to approach you in real life, it's not so much the case of walking right up to someone and being like, hey baby. In fact, trust me, I've experimented with this. When you do that, it may tend to be overwhelming for him and a bit too much. Instead, however, when you can create reasons and opportunities for him to engage with you in his everyday life and show that you're open to having that support and help from him, then you may find that he's way more receptive to connecting with you. So if you do want to learn about how you can become more proactive, not only at encouraging him to approach you, but all aspects of your dating life, if you really want to put yourself back in the driving seat, I would love to hear from you. Please head over to HayleyQuinn.com/real love, and I've got some more videos over there for you. The final thing to focus on, if you want to suddenly find yourself meeting more men in real life, is you want to approach your interactions with him with a vibe of being a little bit playful and a little bit cheeky. So instead of saying, is that seat taken? You could say, can I steal your seat? Is it all right if I sneak in and take your place at the bar? Just by using those odd little playful phrases like, can I steal that? Can I sneak that? It immediately demonstrates to him, again, you're not approaching this social interaction with him from a place of formality or from a place where you're going to be harsh or that you may reject him. You're showing playfulness and warmth, which is super attractive and also switches him on to the fact there could be an opportunity here to extend the conversation. So if at the moment you feel frustrated that you're not meeting men in the way that you want and you're feeling kind of demotivated by the dating process as a whole, I can really understand that. But I guess my challenge to you would be, instead of kind of blaming how modern men are, can we instead challenge ourselves to engage with the world differently and in a way that creates more opportunities to get the interactions that we want? If you've liked this video, I would really appreciate a like, a comment, or a share with someone who may need it. And of course, if you are open to hearing a little bit more advice from me, I would also love it if you subscribe to my channel. See you soon.